Hello everyone. The damage formula, as you may know it, may be incomplete if you're using the one on the WhatsApp Realms wiki. Today I'll present you the complete damage formula with all factors. I can also tell you the defense and magic resistance of Drake Chasm stages from hard to nightmare 4 and likely for Abyss 1 as well. If you watched my last video where I compared defense reduction and vulnerability, you might know how I came up to the conclusion that the damage formula on the WhatsApp Realms wiki is not accurate. To briefly repeat it, I found that when I reduce a target's defense, the damage gain is the same for each hero. Therefore, by dividing the damage gain by the defense reduction, I should get the target's defense. However, this defense was not the same value that I found calculated by subtracting a hero's attack from the damage they dealt. Also, if I did this for different heroes, I would get different defense values, so it was time for me to figure out the whole story. For my testing, I took two different heroes with not too many damage modifiers on their attacks to make my life easier. One who dealt magic damage and one who dealt physical damage. My chosen heroes were here Boreas for magic damage and Astrid for physical damage. Then I cycled through the Drake Chasm stages for hard through Abyss 1 and recorded the auto attack values. Between each cycle I increased the attack of my heroes so I could later see how their damage developed with their increasing attack. Before I plotted my data to find the damage formula, I had to divide the damage my test heroes dealt by their damage modifiers. Boreas has an auto attack modifier of 105%, so I divided his damage by 1.05 and I divided Astrid's damage by 1.1 accordingly. When we have a look at the graph I plotted for each difficulty for both magic and physical damage, we see that most of them are nice linear functions. As we move to higher difficulties, we realize that the functions start to bend sharply at lower attack values. That are commonly known as when a hero attack value becomes too low, causing them to deal a minimum of 5% of their attack value to their target. Because these values do not scale with attack, I could remove them from the plot. This allowed me to fit all damage functions for difficulties hard up to Nightmare 4. Since I did not have any physical damage dealers, with which I could test Abyss 1 formula, had to use a trick to calculate it. But more on this later. And back to our found functions. In case you don't remember from school, a linear function has a slope that is multiplied by the x value on the x-axis, which is in our case the attack value of our heroes. On top of this, the b value is added, which is the y-intercept of the function. For those interested in the calculation of the defense from the defense reduction, if the defense of a target is reduced by 30%, assuming that the damage increases linearly with increasing attack, I only need to divide the damage gain from the defense reduction by 30%. In this way, I get the total damage I would deal if the defense were reduced to 0, which is equal to the target's defense. In this case, the fact that my so found defense values are also found in the damage formula is no accident. Because why should there be a defense if it's not represented in the damage formula? And the slope can't be the defense because they're all the same. So an increasing defense in this game means a parallel shift of the linear function by decreasing the y-intercept. In this respect, the damage formula on the Watcher of Realms wiki is closed by stating that the defense or respectively the magic resistance is subtracted from the attack value. It's just missing the factor in front of the attack. Also, the respective defense and magic resistance values are missing for each difficulty. Before I speak about the Abyss 1 damage formula, I go over the magic damage formulas first. When we look at the graph for the magic resistance, we see that it's the same as with the defense. For each difficulty, we have a linear function that is parallel shifted downwards with increasing magic resistance. The slope values are also the same as those for the defense values with a value of 0.7. But what is interesting is that the magic resistance seems to be lower than the defense values for Nightmares 3 and 4. Which one of you might be interested in exploiting by using magic dealing heroes for this difficulty? With magic resistance covered, I do now like to talk about the formula for Abyss 1. By stacking attack on Kinesa, I was able to obtain a damage value which was clearly above the 5% mark. But to fit a linear function, we need two values. Accordingly, I first try to fit a function through the Tata point obtained with Kinesa and a previously obtained defense value from the defense reduction test. The resulting slope from this fit was around 0.6, which was, compared to the other values of 0.7, too odd. So I assumed that in the test, where I obtained defense value, my attack was so slow, which led to inaccuracies. This led me to adjust my approach. In my second try to derive the representing function for abyss1, I assumed that the slope of 0.7 is correct for each function. Accordingly, with my one obtained tata point at 20,300 attack and 2,300 damage, I calculated the function. For the boss defense in abyss1, I so calculated the value 11,258. If you have heroes like Sun Wukong or Kigiri, it would be nice if you can do some more testing and confirm that this damage formula for Abyss 1 is correct, or share the correct one with everyone in the comments, if mine is too far off. Now we've got a bunch of formulas for each difficulty, but how do we calculate the final DPS from it? The found correlations are used to calculate the base damage of our heroes based on their attack. To calculate the final DPS, we still need to apply the damage modifiers that are given in spell descriptions and the critical damage. To implement a crit chance into the formula, ranging from 0 to 100%, I first split the formula into two parts, where the left part is the base damage we always deal, regardless of critical hit or not, and the right part that represents the damage dealt on top of the base value to the critical hits. For example, with a critical damage of 150%, when we crit, we deal 50% additional damage on top of the base damage. Accordingly, in our formula, we calculate the base damage and add on top of it the base damage again, but multiply it with the crit chance and critical damage. Before we insert the critical damage in the formula, we need to make sure that we subtracted 100% from it, else the calculation is inaccurate since the 100% is already the base damage we have on our left side of the formula. In the final step, we apply the damage modifiers from skills, defense reduction, and so on. For this, we set brackets around the formula and multiply each modifier with it. To confirm that the found formulas are valid, I use Creed and Iona as magic damage dealers, Inkinesa and Alara as physical damage dealers. With them, I tested if I could predict the damage dealt in each dungeon with the obtained formulas and compared them against the real damage. By inserting attack values into the formulas, I calculated the Y value, in this case the unmodified damage from critical damage or skill scaling. In the next step, the modifiers from skills and critical hits were applied. The so calculated values deviated by less than 1% from the real damage values. To summarize this video from previous testing, the Tata suggested that the damage formula in Watch of Realms is likely incomplete. Accordingly, testing was done where damage values were obtained for different attack values. From these values, different linear functions could be fitted, which represents the damage formulas for the different difficulties of Drake Chasm. Since there wasn't enough data to fit a function for Abyss 1, two suggestions for a possible formula were made. I hope this more accurate formula helps you to understand Watch of Realms better, and if this video was helpful for you, please consider liking and subscribing. And most of all, have a nice day.